In today's session, we will discuss about persistence profiles. You would understand what persistence profile is. When do we need to configure persistence profile and common types of persistence profiles. Before I start persistence profile, let's understand lab topology and basic configuration. So here we have F5 box, external IP address 114.30.77.54/29. This is the gateway. Internal IP address 192.168.1.100. There are three servers. They all are running HTTP application. That is TCP port 80, which is the default port. Server 1, server 2, and server 3. We have virtual IP address configured here, 114.30.77.53. It's a publicly routable IP address. These are public IPs, and here RFC 1918 address, non-routable over the internet. Alright. Let me open. So here we have configured three nodes, node 1, node 2, and node 3. They all are in good shape because they all are reachable status. You can see from here, like green. So they all are reachable here. And it's basically ICMP health check, which ensures IP reachability with the node only. And one pool is created here, a web pool, with the HTTP health monitor, which ensures service check, service health monitor. There are three members, node 1, node 2, node 3, with the service port 80. Default load balancing method, round robin, priority group activation is disabled. Now let's have a look on this virtual server. So we have one virtual server here, HTTP virtual server. Source IP address, any IP address, destination address is 114.30.77.53, which is virtual IP address, service port is 80, which is HTTP default port. And there is one profile associated with this, which is TCP profile, and the same TCP profile on client side and as well as server side. And this is the default profile. Whenever we create a standard virtual server type, standard virtual server, so at least one layer 4 profile is associated. But layer 4 profile, not layer 7 profile. That means this F5 big IP will inspect data present in this layer 3 header and layer 4 header, but not in layer 7 header, right? Data. So layer 3, layer 4, but no layer 7, right? Why? Because HTTP profile is not associated with this virtual server. So this F5 big IP will not be able to track down the HTTP request and response messages. So let's say this is my F5 device, internet side, and here like we have three members. So this F5 big IP will not be in a position to figure out or to track HTTP response and request messages. And that is required when we configure fastest load balancing method or even in the static space. So, but let's not get into those stuff as of now. And the web pool is associated with virtual server. So we have three members. They all belong to this web pool, and this web pool is associated with the virtual server. Okay, so let's verify this. So and let me check my IP address. What is my IP address? So my IP address is 115.97.202.118. okay, now it's virtual IP address 53. So it is very much in shape, in fact. So this client request is directed to this server 192.168.1.1, right? And then after one refresh, I just hit down Control F5, then it goes to 192.168.1.2. It's just because of round robin load balancing method. Then again 1.1, right? Maybe 1.3 next time. So this is the default, sorry, default load balancing method, default behavior, which is round robin. So basically, client requests coming from this IP address, this is the source IP address, destined to virtual IP address, which is 114.3.77.53, which is destination virtual IP address, or three variants here, like with this F5 box. And then on the basis of configured load balancing method and as well as availability of servers, request is directed to any specific server, right? Maybe 1.1.3, next connection might go to 1.2, the next connection maybe 1.1, right? Because it's as per the load balancing method and availability of these servers. So what if these servers are running a stateful application, stateful applications, not stateless? Then for example, let's say any e-commerce websites, right? So let's say you have open up any e-commerce website and you have selected one item from one place, then another item from another place, then another item from another place, right? So in this kind of application, like a stateful application, not in case of stateless is okay, like even connection is directed to different server, different member, no point to worry, right? But in case if the application would have been a stateful application, then client requests a particular session must be directed to the same server, right? No load balancing method at all, no round robin sort of thing. But how to ensure this? How to ensure that F5 is not going to use load balancing method? It's going to maintain persistency. That means client requests will be directed to the same server. Client will stay connected to the same server. So basically, to configure that, to ensure that, in fact, there are two commonly used methods. One is source address affinity persistence profile. Persistence profile, right? Source address affinity persistence profile. What happens? The very first request comes onto this F5 big IP, basically onto this virtual server. Associated pool, which is web pool. So it goes to a web pool, which is associated with this virtual server. And since there are three members in this pool, server 1, server 2, server 3. And load balancing method is round robin, which is default load balancing method. And all these three servers are available. So on the basis of load balancing method and availability of these servers, this client request will be directed to one of the member. Let's assume it goes to server 1. All right. Very first it. Another connection comes onto the same virtual server. Connection 2. Hit 2. And if we have associated this source address affinity persistence profile with the virtual server, so what this F5 big IP LTM does, it maintains persistence record database. What exactly this database is? Basically, F5 big IP will maintain client IP address, database of client IP address mapped with member IP address. So let's say my first request goes to server 1, which is 192.168.1.1, and my IP address is 115.97.202.118. So this F5 big IP LTM box will maintain this database, mapping of client IP with the member IP address for a specific length of time, and this time is by default 180 seconds, right? So for 180 seconds, if another connection, second, third, fourth connection, fifth connection within the specified time, within the specific length of time, which is 180 seconds, and it hits down the same virtual server, right? And we have already associated source address affinity profile with this virtual server. It means now FI big IP maintains persistence record, persistence database record that is client IP address mapped with member IP address. So what happens? In fact, this FI big IP checks persistence record database, and if there would have been matching entry here, like if it finds any IP associated with this client IP address, so load balancing method is not used, right? Client connection will be directed to the same server. It means it is just on the basis of persistence record database, and if there would not have been any matching entry here in the persistence record database, then again the fallback method would be load balancing method. So on the basis of load balancing method, client connection might be directed to different member. So this address source address persistence profile supports all services, so as there is no limitation. But what if a lot of clients, there are a lot of too many clients and they all are sitting behind a NAT device, so whether connection is originated from this computer, this computer, this computer, or this computer, because they all will be using private IP addresses like RFC 1918 addresses. So and here you must have been configured like many to one translation, which is your PAT overloading or hide net, whatever, like this is as per the device, like what device we have been using here. So for this FI big IP, all the connections would be coming from the same IP address, right? External IP address of this device. So what would happen? All connections will be directed to the same server, no load balancing method at all. So definitely this is one of the major drawback of source address affinity profile. Another drawback, this box will have to maintain database, persistence record database, right? And by default for individual IP, because mask is /32, not for a specific subnet or network. And even if there would have been two devices in pair, like HA mode, right, then you would have to configure mirroring of this persistence record database, right? So this would be synchronized or replicated with another box, redundant pair. Let's configure this, then we'd go to another option, another method. So let me open up this FI big IP. So to configure source address persistence profile, click onto this local traffic, then go to profiles, and here persistence profile, right? We have a lot of built-in profiles here. They can be used as a parent profile to create a new profile, even they can be used as it is, but it's not recommended. You should always create a new profile, right? And these built-in profiles can be used as a parent profile only. So click here on create, and name mandatory field marked with the blue color. So let's say lab source address persistence profile, persistence type, which is basically your parent profile. Select source address affinity from here, and this is your parent profile, source address affinity profile, and here configuration page. If let's say we want to edit some option from here, then on the right hand side there is a box here, just click onto this option, and then these options would be highlighted, right? As of now they all have been grayed out. Here see, timeout is 180 seconds, which is the default. Prefix length is by default /32, which is 255, 255, 255, 255. Okay, so let me change some parameter from here. Let me change this timeout to 60 seconds, or maybe 180, maybe 120 second. Prefix length, if you want to configure something here, then you can specify your IPv4 prefix length here. If the default is what? 32 means find usual IPs. Okay, finished. Once is created, then go to virtual server, HTTP virtual server properties, and here apply this persistence profile, lab source address persistence profile, right? Update. So the very first client request will be directed to any member, right, on the basis of load balancing method and of course availability of server. But subsequent connections, connection number 2, connection number 3, connection number 4, they will not be directed on the basis of load balancing method, because F5 pass will check first is persistence database record, and if the same has been found there, no need to apply the load balancing method, right? But yes, if there not have been any entry in the persistence database record, then again the same load balancing method. Okay, let me close down this window and see, just my IP address is 114.97.202.118. Okay, and let me access this the very first time, 53, control F5, refresh. So continuously I'm refreshing this page by F5, but see here, the 1.1 was from the cache memory only. So here is 192.168.1.2. So even after 5 or 6 time control F5, same server, right? 1.2. It means it's just because of persistence profile. Now for the further verification, go to this statics tab and then local traffic. From here, persistence records. And see here, there is no default or like persistence record database over here. Persistence record statics display has been disabled in the GUI. You can enable it by executing the following command in TMSH traffic manager shell. And what's the command here? Just copy it from here. Copy CLI access of the device. So already I have SSH to the box. Get into TMSH traffic manager shell here. Okay, right click, paste, done. Okay, we are very much in good shape now. Quit from here, come out of this TMOS and refresh one more time here. And open up the site again, because no database entry here. Because default timeout is 60 seconds only, that is 1 minute. So after 1 minute, entry would be deleted from here. See here. So let me check my IP address one more time. What is my IP address? So my IP address is 115.97.202.1.8. Here it is, persistence value, and thus check the IP address here. 192.168.1.1/80, and what is the pool? Web pool, and this is the age out time. So that means for the next connection, the next client request originating from the same IP address will be directed to this member, right? And this member is of this from this pool, web pool. So just on the basis of this persistence record database, client request will be directed. But yes, if there not have been any entry here, like it's blank, or maybe from a new IP address, different IP address, which is not listed here, then the fallback method is load balancing. It means no specific match, no entry in the persistence record database, it goes to load balancing method. So it's one of the way, like how to configure persistence profile. The next method is, so let me open up. So it was your source address affinity. Source address affinity. The next one is cookie persistence. What is cookie in fact, and what cookie persistence profile is? So in cookie persistence profile, however, there are three different mode here. In fact, the very first one is, which is default, is insert mode. The next one is rewrite. And the third one is passive mode. This is the default and commonly used cookie persistence method, insert mode. What exactly this insert mode is, let me explain. Okay, so this is my client machine. First hit, this is F5 box, client request, first hit onto this virtual server, no cookie, no data inside HTTP header. Cookie just a small data written inside HTTP header, right? And but being the very first connection, being the very first hit, there won't be any cookie inside the HTTP header. So what F5 does now, it checks the pool associated with the virtual server, and then load balancing method configured on a specific pool, and then availability of members of from that pool, and on the basis of that, client request will be directed to any member. Let's say it goes to server 3. So no cookies here, server 3. Now HTTP response comes back from server 3, still no cookies at all, right? So no cookies. Now when F5 sends HTTP response to the original client, now F5 inserts cookie here. Cookie is inserted inside HTTP header. Now what would happen? Second hit, second connection, right? This would have now cookie inside HTTP header. What F5 will do now? F5 will check the cookie present inside HTTP header, and on the basis of cookie, client connection will be directed to the same member, right? No load balancing method at all. Let me explain, this point is important. So let me open up pen brush again here. Alright. So what I was discussing here, like this is a F5 box, it's my server side connection here, and it's a client. So let's say this is client F5 big IPLTM box here, and this is my server. Server means member, any member. Alright, so and I'm just talking about the very first hit. No cookies, and then a response comes back, no cookies and no cookies. First connection. Then the second connections, no cookies, and then cookies, and this is second connection. So here, let me this is first hit and this is second hit. Okay, so this is the first HTTP request, no cookies, with no cookies, right? Okay, HTTP request with no cookies, HTTP reply with no cookies. then again HTTP reply here with cookies here. Cookies is just a small data written inside HTTP header after doing some mathematical computation, right? So this cookies will have some information like big IP server, and then maybe this pool name, right? And then some 120 bits, I believe, hexadecimal characters computed by F5 big IP. So some value encoded inside that. So whenever client sends second connection, so this HTTP request will have cookies present inside HTTP header. Now what would happen? Okay. So now this HTTP request, hits down onto F5 like box, this LTM box. It open up HTTP header, right? It finds cookie inside this HTTP header, performs some mathematical computation, calculation, and then extract server IP address from this cookie only. So there is no need to check the load balancing method. On the basis of this cookie data, client request will be directed to the same server, right? So for the very first hit, load balancing method. Second hit, third, fourth, fifth, maybe within the same session, no load balancing method at all. But limitation of cookie persistence profile is what? It is only supported by browsers like HTTP or HTTPS only. So it doesn't support all services, whereas source address affinity profile persistence profile supports all services. So it's one of the major limitation, right? Cookie persistence profile cannot be associated with any other service apart from HTTP or HTTPS. And even in case if this would have been HTTPS, then SSL termination or SSL offloading, which is basically client SSL profile, would become mandatory, right? So I don't want to get into those stuff as of now, SSL profile and all that, but this would become mandatory at that point of time. And you understand why this would become important, because LTM will have to read data present inside this HTTP header or HTTPS header. So in case of HTTPS, this data would be encrypted, scrambled, right? And without a symmetric key, this data cannot be decrypted. And without decryption, this F5 box will not be able to figure out to which member this request would have been directed to. So, and even in case of HTTP traffic, even HTTP profile would become mandatory now, right? So for source address affinity profile, only TCP profile was there, and even HTTP profile is not required or not mandatory sort of thing. But if you want to apply or associate this cookie persistence profile with the virtual server, then HTTP profile would be mandatory, would be required. And just check the configuration here. And even if we do not associate HTTP profile with the virtual server straight away, if we want to configure cookie persistence profile, so immediately would be returned with an error message. Okay, first apply HTTP profile, and then because it's a dependency as well. So let's configure that. So go to local traffic, and then profiles, persistence profile, create cookie persistence profile cookie, and default is HTTP. See here, like let me clear this. Okay, so here it is, HTTP cookie insert mode. This is the default mode, right? And we have a rewrite option, we have pache mode, etc. Okay, so let's not change this. Okay, and expiration is what? Session cookie. Okay, finished. No error message because we have just created profile. But if I want to associate this profile with this virtual server, so let me open this HTTP virtual server resource. Go to default persistence profile, try to associate this cookie persistence profile with this, and immediately there would be an error message stating that HTTP profile is required, is mandatory. So without HTTP profile, you cannot associate this. Yes, here it is. Cookie persistence profile require an HTTP or fast HTTP profile to be associated with virtual server. And even if we check the statistics from here, like local traffic and the summary, so pools, so here it is, web pool. So check here, even we like these statistics of connections, but what about HTTP requests? Zero. It's all zero, right? Why it is zero? Because there is no HTTP profile associated with the virtual server. So even this F5 big IP is not able to figure it out, like number of requests or responses, right? And even the same is required for fastest load balancing method, because F5 will have to figure out outstanding layer 7 connections. So go back to this virtual server again, associate HTTP profile first before associating or applying cookie persistence profile. So select this HTTP profile default, apply this, update. Once it's done, then again we'll go to resource tab, and then we would associate cookie persistence profile with this. Cookie persistence profile, update. All right. And in the meantime, let me close down this, update it. Yes, done. Okay, let me open Wireshark and to just do the some capture here, packet capture. Okay, capture is in progress and it's done. It is in good shape now, and let me capture HTTP header as well from here, and just type your IP address 53. And one more thing, if I can have this server, so I will capture packet onto this member as well, but since we're not sure like whether first request will be directed to server 1, server 2 or server 3, but let's try just open up here, because we're not sure like to which server this connection, first connection would be directed to. Okay, now just hit on this 53. Oh, sorry, it goes to 1.2. okay, so the very first connection goes to 1.2, and check the HTTP header here, and we'll check the next one. User isn't, and there are some cookies here, like, but it's not F5 big IP cookies. So because this would be from big IP server, and the some text messages here, and the user isn't. And before that, let me open this Wireshark first. Okay, and put down some filter here, IP address 453. So let me open this. This is my private IP address 192.168.1.11, and the public IP is 114.30. correct. Open up this. This is the very first request, and get request, it contains host address, connection, keep alive. What's the keep alive is here? Keep alive is like HTTP version 1.1 onwards, they do support keep alive mechanism. It means the client is in charge of maintaining this connection, right? So client sends a request, server responds, again client send request, server responds, client send request, server responds. Once it is done, then client send the finished flag to just terminate the connection. In previous versions like HTTP 0.9 or maybe even 1.0, is capable of supporting keep alive, but by default keep alive is disabled. In HTTP 0.9, keep alive was not supported. It means just after first HTTP request and response on the existing TCP connection, server just disconnect the or terminate the TCP connection. So again, client initiate three-way handshake, a new connection, then HTTP request, server response, and then again disconnection. So finally, in version 1.1, the keep alive became default behavior. So keep alive almost HTTP version 1.1, this version 1.1 supports keep alive. So it's keep alive, and host is this user agent, which is browser, what browser we are using here. And the accepted encoding is about the HTTP compression. Compression is supported, right? And the gzip, gun zip method, and accept language US English. Okay, all right. And full response is this. So as a, there is no cookie at all. So this might be the very first request, right? So check another HTTP GET request from the same IP. Here it is, the next request. And before that, the very first GET, and it was the acknowledgement and then response here, page not found or something. So response, see here. Yes, here is the response. So client request goes to F5, no cookies. Then F5 directs client request to member. Member send response back to F5, and then finally F5 sends response back to the client with cookies now. And where it is here, set cookies, big IP server, and the pool name web pool, and then some value here. Here it is, right? And this web pool. So is the second. Now the next client request will carry this cookie, right? And F5 we'll check this cookie, and on the basis of this cookie, member would be selected. It means the client request will be directed to the same member, no load balancing method at all. So just check the next request generated or initiated from the same computer. Here it is, HTTP 1.1, and this request, here it is, this request has cookie in this. But one more important point here, you'll have to ensure that, and even if we just if we check the this HTTP header from here, so again you'll find the same cookie here as well, big IP authentication cookies, and then maybe the next packet. It's a HTTP header extension, Google Chrome extension, a best way to just capture the header, HTTP header only. So in this way you can check header of any, like, so however it's not relevant here. So let me show you one more thing here. In case if you go to advanced and then content setting, you'll have to ensure that this option must be enabled, like selected, allow sites to save and read cookie data. Because in case if you disable this, it means cookie will not be temporarily stored or saved. That means each new connection will be with the no cookies. In fact, F5 will insert cookies, but client requests will not carry any cookie inside HTTP header. So definitely this cookie persistence profile will not work at that point of time, right? So I believe you understand some basic concept of profile, especially these two profiles what we use, and why this persistence is used to ensure a series of connections from a given user are directed to the same pool member. The first time a client connects to an application via the appropriate virtual server, traffic is load balanced on the basis of configured load balancing method, right? So even though a server creates a session in the memory and the session ID is generated, it is sent to the client, but it's not of any use because in between client and server, a five big IP is sitting in between and acting as a reverse proxy, right? Because client connection will get terminated onto F5, and F5 will initiate another connection with the member. So since F5 is sitting in between client and server, so even though server creates a session in memory, a session ID is generated. It passes to the client browser via the cookie in the HTTP response header, but it's not of any use, right? If an application is stateless, there is no need of persistence. But if the application is stateful and persistence is needed to support management for an application, then the virtual server for that application can be configured with a persistence profile. And these two were the commonly used persistence types: source address affinity persistence, and the next one was cookie persistence, right? Source address affinity persistence profile means F5 big IP well maintained persistence record database, and on the basis of that persistence database, client connection will be directed to a particular member, right? No load balancing method at all. But if there would have not been any specific entry or specific match in the persistence database record, then fallback method would be load balancing method. In cookie persistence profile, F5 big IP doesn't maintain any database, right? Even mirroring, like in case of HA, would not be required because cookie is temporarily stored or saved onto the client machine, right? It means client will have to carry cookie inside the HTTP header. F5 will just open up the HTTP header, will check the cookie inside the HTTP header, and on the basis of that, client request will be directed to a specific a particular member, right? But major limitation of cookie persistence profile is what? It only supports HTTP and HTTPS, and even in case of HTTPS, SSL termination, which is client SSL profile, would become mandatory because without that, HTTP encrypted data cannot be decoded. There won't be symmetric key to decode the encrypted data, and without doing that, cookie cannot be checked, cannot be verified. So for cookie persistence profile, even HTTP profile is required. Client SSL profile might be required in case of HTTPS, but for source address affinity persistence profile, HTTP profile is not mandatory, right? Might be associated with the virtual server, but might not be associated, no problem whatsoever, because TCP profile is there and it's more than sufficient because F5 big IP operates either as a like layer 3 or 4 sort of thing. That means reading data present inside layer 3 and 4 header, or maybe layer 7 upper layer data, but only layer 7 if there would have been layer 7 profile associated with the virtual server, right? So it's all about your persistence profiles.